celebrate the 75th anniversary of the NFL with a diamond collection of hits. As big as Nate Newton.
My claim to fame, I push other big guys out of the way so Emmitt can make a lot of yards.
As powerful as Emmitt Smith. And as strong as Reggie White. It's the 1994-95 season home video lineup.
Reggie White gets it.
Whether you love the Bengals, the Bucks,
it's caught, touchdown,
the Bills, the Bears, the Broncos, or the Browns, we have a team video for you. 28 exciting collectible highlights presented as only NFL Films can. How do you pack 75 years of history, action, outrageous characters, legends, stars, and storybook finishes in one video?
And there's a collision. It's caught out of the air. The ball is pulled in by Greg O'Hare. Harris is going for a touchdown.
Can he throw? He can. The ball slipped forward as well. It's a wild scramble.
NFL Films has it all in their special Collector's Diamond Anniversary film.
Recovered in the end zone. The Oakland Raiders.
The right, under pressure,
75 seasons, the officially sanctioned document of everything great about NFL football.
Monday Night Football.
150.
Monday Night Football.
150.
Monday Night Football, baby. The world watching.
The world champion.
For millions, it's the greatest thing to ever happen to Monday nights.
On the season premiere.
Now this special anniversary celebration captures 25 years of great games and magic moments.
Get that Monday night thing going. You ready for some football?
Relive all the memories and the best of 25 years of ABC's Monday Night Football.
Yeah, baby, Monday Night Football is where you gotta be.
Some say the personality makes the man.
Ryan's a know-it-all. Hell, head coaches are supposed to win games, not friends.
I'm Steve Young, quarterback for the San Francisco 49ers, and I'm also an attorney. Personally, I think the two have a lot in common. For instance, you're allowed to make an opening statement, and then the defense can come after you. The punishment usually fits the crime.
Well, basically, I catch the ball and I run.
And I catch the ball and I
catch the ball and I run.
And I
go off the field and definitely outside the lines in the NFL's greatest stars.
Shoot, I'm probably starting to sound like a broken record. That's because I did break records.
Straight from a secret ballot, get the 100 goofiest, zaniest, funniest, klutziest plays in the history of the NFL. They're all here in the deliriously entertaining NFL 100 Greatest Follies.
Until that clock's at 0-0, no matter what, or the field goal's kicked, or we score the touchdown, it's not over. All you see is really white lines and boundaries. Once you get starting in motion and you're in a two-minute drill, things are going so fast that you don't even think about it.
Huddle up. Come on, Bobby, set a huddle, let's go!
There's nothing like a victory snatched from the jaws of defeat. Like a magician, John Elway can make the final minutes of a game last forever.
It's caught.
You can say what you want to. I don't think I want anybody back there except number 7.
Nail-biting drama, action-packed highlights in John Elway's greatest comebacks.
Let's go, we're gonna get some respect today. Respect.
All day long. Let's just kick that foot all day long.
The third installment in the NFL's hit collection of rock music video brings the hottest new bands, the hottest new songs in an alternative look at the NFL. NFL Rocks on the Edge. Join country music sensation Lori Morgan in a high-stepping, boot-scooting football hoedown.
This is when the big dogs come up.
There's a good time.
Starts tonight with a win, all right? On three. This is my night to go crazy just to see how it feels. I'm gonna dress up, gonna let my hair down like a wildcat on the prowl.
Get there!
This is my night to howl.
Top hits and top stars from the stage and the gridiron in NFL Honky Tonk Country. Wrap up the season with the most anticipated sporting event around the world with the Super Bowl 29 home video coming to you in February of 1995. NFL Team Videos, 75 seasons, the best of 25 years of Monday Night Football, John Elway's greatest comebacks, NFL's 100 greatest follies, NFL's greatest stars, NFL Rocks on the Edge, NFL Honky Tonk Country, and Super Bowl 29. It's the greatest lineup in sports video history, worth its weight in gold. Dazzling as diamonds in this very special 75th anniversary year from NFL Films. Chargers began the first Sunday of the 93 season poised to defend their AFC Western Division championship crown. Before the largest opening day home crowd in franchise history, the defense completely grounded the Seahawks. Seattle's attack failed to score a touchdown, while John Carney began his quest to become San Diego's all-time single-season scorer by blasting a team record 6 field goals. As it turned out, Carney's kicks were all the points the Chargers needed.
Third and 2 from the 11. Rick Meyer, play action, wants to throw. Steps up, throws, it's caught over the middle. Receiver gets knocked down, blades his tackle, fumbles the ball! It's loose at the 1, San Diego takes over!
With their victory over the division rival Seahawks, the Chargers were off and running, posting their first opening day win since 1986. In 1993, more fans filed into Jack Murphy Stadium to see the Chargers than in any previous season. A key figure behind this groundswell of support and the team's on-field effort was head coach Bobby Ross.
He's probably one of the most disciplined people I've ever met. He's very organized. He's a workaholic. He works incessantly. He's always there. And he really looks into the personalities of the players. They're just not players that, you know, he looks at and they're there from 8 to 5 or whatever. I mean, he cares about them as individuals and he knows his players very closely. He keeps a close relationship with them.
From all-pro superstars right on down to Suicide Squad wedgebusters, Ross understood and defined each athlete's role on the Chargers, starting with the kicking units.
Deep in the end zone, he wants to bring it out, runs
fumble.
To the bench, fumble the ball. It's loose at the 20-yard line. I think San Diego's got it, yes!
Doug Miller, Eric Cassel, Terry Crews, James Fuller, and special teams MVP Lewis Bush were told to drive opponents back to their goal line, and they did it better than anyone else in the NFL. Meanwhile, rookie Darian Gordon added his own brand of excitement to the punt return team.
On the run, Gordon breaks a tackle, coming left through another tackle to the 45, to the 40, speeds to the 30, breaking down the sidelines to the 20. Darian Gordon zigzagging across the field.
The Chargers' top draft pick of 1993 finished third in the league in punt return average and started the last 6 games at right corner, accomplishments that earned him a spot on the NFL's all-rookie squad. Gordon teamed in the secondary with Sean Van Horst. and another former first rounder, free safety Stanley Richard. The man known as the Sheriff has one particularly arresting quality. He hits opponents like a ton of bricks. San Diego's big play defensive back is Darren Carrington, who, like Richard, is only too happy to deliver a resounding blow. But Darren's long suit is a knack for pass pattern larceny. And with his 7 steals, Carrington led the Chargers in interceptions for the 2nd straight year. Carrington's takeaways lit the fuse for San Diego's offense, while another Charger ignited the explosion. Let's go! In week 2 at Mile High Stadium, the Denver Broncos discovered firsthand just how difficult it is to contain the multiple skills of running back Ronnie Harmon.
We gotta get Harmon somehow. I don't know how. We gotta play spy on him, I guess. 3rd and long. God, it's killing us.
Harmon disrupted Denver all afternoon with soaring catches and serpentine runs that had the Broncos scratching their heads in disbelief.
What are we doing? Golly, guys made every play.
For Harmon, it was another typical game in another typical season as a San Diego Charger. He finished 2nd on the team in yards from scrimmage, and his 73 catches placed him 3rd among all NFL running backs. It's a good bet that Ronnie Harmon will someday be a candidate for the Chargers Hall of Fame, an honor bestowed on team legends Dan Fouts and Charlie Joyner during week 3 induction ceremonies at the Oilers game. Their achievements on offense were saluted, but on the field, it was the defense that saved the day. Five Charger takeaways came at critical moments, including a pair of interceptions from linebacker Junior Seau.
Moon back to throw, big pressure, throws, intercepted again! Out comes San Diego, Seau at the 40 to the 45, dance into the 50, into the Houston 40, streaking down the sideline to the 30 and out of bounds! Junior Seau, show me your lightning bolt!
For the 2nd time in 3 weeks, John Carney provided the offense. First, by setting an NFL record for consecutive field goals. Then, booting the game winner in the final seconds.
Hold on to your seats. John Carney to attempt a 27-yard field goal, attempting to hit his 6th straight field goal of the game and his 29th in a row. Snap, down, up, good!
After 3 games, the Chargers were still in 1st place in the AFC West, but the winds of fortune were about to change. As the 1993 schedule danced through the summer and headed into October, the Chargers' hopes for another division title began to slip away as San Diego dropped 5 of its next 7 games.
I think that perhaps as a team, we lost a little focus. I think that we had to go through, you know, it had been 10 years since we had won. And I think we had to go through learning how to win. Then we had some critical injuries. We ended up losing 6 starters, and of course, for a part of the time, we lost our starting left tackle, Harry Swain, and then also our quarterback, Stan Humphrey. So we never got into a consistent flow as a football team.
The ailing offensive front missed standouts like Eric Moten, but remained anchored by lineman of the year, Courtney Hall, along with guard Joe Malinicek, 14-year veteran tackle Stan Brock, and youngsters Eric Johnson, Curtis Whitley, and rookie guard Joe Cocuzzo. But one Charger in particular didn't seem to be affected by the line's injury problems. The Chargers' number one pick in the 1994 draft paid off a year in advance with a selection of running back Natron Means. It was a welcome choice in San Diego and an extremely unpopular one with opposing NFL defenses. At 245 pounds, Means is a lethal combination of strength and speed, talents which accounted for a healthy 4 yards per carry rushing average and the most touchdowns scored by any Charger runner or receiver. Natron's muscular high steps and relentless drive to the end zone rejuvenated the running game, a key element in San Diego's mid-season offensive surge that saw the Chargers explode for 30-point performances in wins over the playoff-bound Vikings and Raiders. At Los Angeles, the Coliseum fans were traumatized by the Chargers' prolific and deceptive ground assault.
Raiders got a six-man front on play action end around. Here comes Jefferson, 40 to the 50. Shane Jay into Raider territory and pushed out of bounds.
San Diego's offensive line effectively cleared the way for nearly 200 rushing yards, and then the defense chalked up some yardage of its own.
From the 3-yard line, Hostin little throw, slant, it's intercepted. It's picked off by San Diego. Out to the 20 is Donnie Frank, to the 30, to the 40. He is going to go all the way. Touchdown, San Diego. He takes it coast to coast and scores.
A week later at the Metrodome, the revived Charger attack continued its onslaught against the Vikings.
They run Means. They go straight ahead to the 5, to the goal line. Touchdown, San Diego. Deep drop. They blitz. They pick it up. Goes to the back of the end zone. Touchdown, San Diego. Sean Jefferson.
The offense grabbed a fourth quarter lead. Then the defense made it stick.
Salisbury bootleg right to throw. Looking long throw into Carter. Off his fingertips. Intercepted. And picked off by Van Horst on the deflection. Salisbury to throw, pump fakes under pressure, fumbles the ball! It's picked up by San Diego, it's kicked! Leslie O'Neal picks it up on the run! He's got it at the 30! He laterals to Seau, and the defense has made another big play!
For the second consecutive season and the fourth time in his career, defensive end Leslie O'Neal was voted to the Pro Bowl and was named San Diego's co-recipient of the team MVP award. The franchise's all-time sack leader continued to add to his total with another dozen in 1993, best among the Chargers.
Leslie had a very fine year, another very good and consistent year, but you've got to remember that he was double-teamed and sometimes even triple-teamed quite a bit. But I thought the thing that really stood out for Leslie was the fact that against the really good people, he probably played his best.
O'Neal's pass rushing skills are well documented, but those who play against him each week are constantly reminded of his run stopping capabilities as well.
They're going to run Marcus here in the backfield and drop. Leslie O'Neal with an inside rush nearly took the ball out. He may have taken his breath out.
Sharing MVP honors with O'Neal was linebacker Junior Seau, the Chargers' leading tackler for the third consecutive year. There are a few defenders in the NFL who play the game with more enthusiasm. But Seau understands there is more to the leader's role than merely being the one who speaks the loudest.
Leadership is consistency. It's going out there and performing and doing the things that you have to do to win. And you get respect by that. I approach every play as a game. The whole picture is winning every play, not just the whole four-quarter game. syndrome. I'm looking at every play winning every down.
Such confrontations were battles he seldom lost and were part of the reason why Junior Seau earned All-Pro and Pro Bowl honors for the third straight season. When quarterback Stan Humphries returned to the starting lineup in late November, the fortunes of the San Diego Chargers improved dramatically.
Stan Humphries separated his shoulder in the last preseason game against the 49ers, and he was the guy that they looked to offensively and defensively. And when Stan got hurt, he tried to play, and he just wasn't the same guy. And it wasn't until later in the season that he was 100% healthy. And when that happened, then the team played well.
Against the Colts on Monday Night Football, Humphries led the Chargers to their most decisive victory of the season.
Deep drop, Humphries to throw, looking long, throw it deep to Shay-J. He caught it, touchdown, San Diego.
Stan Humphries, I thought at the end of the season, when he came back from his injury, the last six football games, was actually playing better than he had even in the previous year when he took us to the playoffs. I think a big reason for that was the fact that we started to minimize our turnovers. We cut back on those quite a bit, and I thought he was playing better than he had played at any time since we've been together.
Humphrey's cannon arm was potent as usual. But what San Diego realized more than ever was how greatly Stan's absence affected the team, and how vital his skills and influence are to the Chargers' success.
My leadership, I think, comes basically by what I do on the field. I try to kind of lead by example on the field. What if I'm out there busting at every play, doing whatever I can to win this football game, the other guys around you are going to see that and you're going to follow that. The winning is what you, it's why you play the game for Sunday or Monday night, whenever you play. To walk off the field a winner is, there's no greater feeling. And to get to the ultimate, the Super Bowl, and to win it, there's nothing greater. That's why you play the football game.
Without a healthy Stan Humphries, San Diego struggled. But with his return, the Chargers rolled up four victories in their final six games. Easily the most suspenseful win came at home against Denver. O'Neill, Seau, Carrington, and company made life miserable for Broncos quarterback John Elway and did not allow a single touchdown against the AFC's top-scoring offense.
Deep drop, fires up the sidelines, tipped into the air, intercepted by San Diego's Carrington. Off the deflection and down to the 37.
The Chargers rallied to tie the score in the second half, and then Humphries ran the two-minute drill to perfection, setting the stage for another last-second comeback victory.
Stan Humphries back to throw on first down, pumps, throws long, Barnes, did he catch it? Yes! Johnny Barnes, somehow he kept his feet in bounds. San Diego's been running uphill all day. A 35-yard field goal to win it. Snap, down, on the way, goal!
Three weeks later against the Dolphins, a Monday night TV audience watched as Humphries and the Chargers exacted a full measure of revenge against the team that had knocked San Diego from the playoffs the year before.
Everybody into the pattern, Humphries to throw, caught by Harmon at the 10, to the 5, he scores! Touchdown, San Diego!
Just before the half, Humphries broke Miami's back on a wing and a prayer of a Hail Mary pass.
Back to throw, second down and long, looks, launches it deep, throwing it into triple coverage in the end zone. It's going to be tipped up, caught, hit it, caught, touchdown! Can you believe that? The ball was deflected up in the air and Miller came down with it.
The woozy Dolphins were staggering. Then Natron Means added three rushing touchdowns to deliver the knockout punch.
From the 35, they're going to run Natron Means, nowhere to go, slips through the hole, goes to the 40, streaks to the 50, to the 40, down to the 30, two guys can chase him down to the 5, he scores! 65-yard run by the in-train!
With one more victory in the final week, San Diego avoided a losing season. and created a wave of momentum that would point the Chargers in the right direction for 1994. Recapturing the magic of the 92 season in 1994 is the goal of Alex Spanos, his sons, Dean and Michael, and general manager Bobby Bethard.
Bethard has never been afraid to make a decision. And that's one of the reasons why, if I'm starting a team tomorrow, he's one of the two or three guys who I'd want to run it. His decisiveness and his judgment of talent over the long haul is going to win them games. I think that the best quiet move in the offseason was made when the Chargers re-signed Courtney Hall, a young player who could dominate his position for 8 years. And to me, Courtney Hall, along with Steve Everett of the Browns, will be the two best centers for the rest of this decade. And I think that to sign him and to make sure that he was the one that didn't get away was the best thing they could have done.
Bethard also moved quickly to sign All-Pro Junior Seau to a long-term deal, the first step in his offseason plan to strengthen and reshape the Charger defense.
Well, we've tried to shore up some positions at defensive tackle. We signed Reuben Davis. We think that that gives us the big guy inside in the defensive line that we've been missing.
Davis, number 93, will join holdover linemen Chris Mims, Sean Lee, Reggie White, and Ray Lee Johnson, major contributors to last season's second-ranked defense against the run. The defensive line will gain even more run-stopping support from ex-Detroit Lion Dennis Gibson, number 98, a savvy 7-year veteran at inside linebacker. Another addition to the linebacking core is Miami's David Griggs, number 92, a fast closing defender with exceptional pass rushing instincts. The secondary will improve with former Seahawk cornerman Dwayne Harper, number 29, one of the brightest and most tenacious pass defenders in the AFC.
Well, we do have a good team. We have a competitive team. I think Dwayne Harper coming in and the maturity of Darian Gordon at the other corner, I think these guys will come up and play at a better level or a higher level this year. And that's what we've done on defense.
Offensively, the Chargers begin the year with proven commodities at tight end and H-back. Dwayne Young, Alfred Pupunu, Deems May, and Mike Dial are relentless blockers with surprisingly agile receiving skills. Along with runner Eric Bieniemy and returning wideout Sean Jefferson, Johnny Barnes, and Mark Say, San Diego has added two playoff-tested scoring threats. Number 89, Tony Martin, was one of Dan Marino's most reliable targets in Miami, with the ability to stretch short gains into long ones and rainbow passes into pot of gold touchdowns. Number 82, Vance Johnson, an old nemesis from Denver, will bring his acrobatics to the Murph in 94. Few receivers know or have performed better against AFC West competition than Johnson. Additional talent from the draft and fresh ideas from new members of the coaching staff will help Bobby Ross to reach his primary objective in 1994.
I think the initial goal would be to get back into the playoffs. I think this, that after having been in them for 1 year and then sat out and watched them the second year, it's just there's a tremendous feeling of emptiness if you're not there. And I think that all of us within our entire organization are geared to wanting to get to that point again.
The pride and satisfaction of 1992 is still fresh in the minds of the Chargers, who are now healed and have learned from the experience of the past season. They are dedicated to bringing a championship back to San Diego. And Bobby Bethard and Bobby Ross have improved the team's chances with a well-coordinated plan which has added a balanced blend of youth and experience to the franchise's existing talent. The growing season of 1993 has ended. The Chargers are now ready to reap the benefits as they strive for a return to the playoffs in 1994.